A few days ago, I published a video which I said I was disappointed that I missed out on the CSX Heritage units coming through the state of North Carolina. And somebody commented that I should just get on Facebook and see where the trains are, because that's what all the normal people do. And I think to myself, I am not normal people, in case you didn't already notice that. Because unlike other people who sign away all their rights and the terms and conditions on Facebook and Twitter and everything else for free, I sign away my rights and the terms and conditions of YouTube, and I get paid enormous sums of money by YouTube because I publish so many videos. Actually, my Freeman channel should not be making any money at all, but I seem to be glitching out the system by publishing a video every day. So it doesn't care if I don't have 1,000 subscribers. Yeah. And so, also, I don't want to be on any sort of social media because I have committed many crimes against the galaxy. And there's no way to track me down now unless you can figure out what this road is right here. Even though I think I've said it in a previous video, what road this is right here. And where my house is, which is right there. Or you could just figure out where I'm going to be and then track me down in person, which shouldn't actually be that hard. Though, based on these videos, he should be at the Transportation Museum next Saturday. So if we play our cards right, we should be able to set up a boulder right here. That way, when he passes the no trespassing sign, he'll trip a string and the boulder will come down and smash his foot, and he will become so angry that he will do something. But I also only made my email address available on this channel, the Freeman one, for a little while. And then I took it down because I was afraid of somebody tracking me down. And what's there to track down? Well, I sell t-shirts on Teespring. And when I say I sell t-shirts, I mean I've sold one. And it was one that I bought myself. And it still hasn't gotten here, even though it's been like 2 weeks. So I'm a little bit unhappy at that. Of course, what am I going to lose by it? I bought my lawnmower train shirt, and then my lawnmower train didn't run. But I'm afraid that people are going to see pictures of shirts like this and go, hey, this shirt right here has a picture of a train on it, and this train looks exactly like our train. And I'll say, if you're talking about Railroad Heritage Weekend last year, yeah, it looks exactly the same. And I'm sorry. But not only will they tell me to take down the shirts, even though I haven't sold any, they might, when they find out about my YouTube ad revenue, they might want their money. They might want a share of that money. Might want a cut. And they'll say, what is my share? You'll be paid an exposure, they'll say. And I'll say, why can't you be paid an exposure? Ha ha! I will keep my money. And what was that? It was the hitman team after me from that railroad. Mm-hmm. Because I have made piles of money off of YouTube. I mean, look at this. And that's just in 1 month. That's just from a channel that shouldn't be making any money at all. But think about how much money Thomas makes. Keep on talking about how much Thomas makes me. I'll tell you about how much Thomas makes me eventually, after I have paid off my bodyguards and after I've bought that bulletproof fleece vest that I've always wanted, and after I add that armor to my lawnmower train, even though my lawnmower train isn't going to be running. I might convert it to pedal power one day. That way I can take it to the rail trails. And I could go, hee 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 hee, and I actually almost bought a bicycle pump for it to operate the whistle so I could just go. Yeah, that was a fun time. But this has been a rough day for me. Today, Saturday, May something. 11th, I think it is. I don't know. The day before this video gets published. You see, here's how my day has been. We planned on going to Gastonia. And we left 2 hours earlier than we intended. And one might say, why? Well, God apparently wanted us to leave 2 hours earlier than we intended, because as soon as we got a mile down the road, we ran over a nail and got a flat tire. My mom's van has never had a flat tire in 20 years of her owning it. Well, it's had it once, but it was in our own garage. And we didn't have to change the tire, we just had to add some Flex Seal. We've been learning stuff from Scott McCloud. Even before Scott McCloud knew how to use Flex Seal, we were using Flex Seal. And so we fixed that tire. We drove back home, dropped the flat tire off, or actually we didn't fix it. Some roadside assistance came out and we had to wait 45 minutes, but we listened to the radio. And then roadside assistance changed the tire, told us that it's good that we didn't change our own tire because our jack was worth jack. And drove back home, we flung the tire out, and we had a van full of recycling stuff, so we went to the recycling center, and we looked at the radar to see if it was going to rain, because it had been raining all morning, as you can tell. And then, after we checked the radar and it looked like it was going to be clear, we ended up getting caught in a flash flood, and we were driving through 6 inches of water in Gastonia, right near the police department, in between Dallas and the police department, going alongside the old Carolina Northwestern. Actually, you can actually see the old Carolina Northwestern where they're building a little overpass over where it used to be, and they're redoing the entrance ramps and the exit ramps off of 321 and 85. And then as we're driving up near the police department, there's like a foot of water on the side of the road. And then I'm thinking to myself, oh, hopefully we can survive. And then my mom's back and cuts off because of the floodwaters. And she's thinking, oh, what a rough day this has been. And I say, put it in reverse. And we do Polar Express reenactments, except we're in liquid water, not frozen water. And we back up into the middle of the road. That way we're dry, because we got the high ground. And then I told my mom, try it again. And she started up the van, and we drove up the hill. And then we went to the recycling center. And when we got to the recycling center, we heard sirens all around in the background, and there was a tornado warning actually going on. We got it on our little smartphones, and we were in the middle of a tornado warning. And then they also got notifications on the phones that there was a flash flood watch and until 3:15, and it was only 2:45 at this point, and everything was going wrong, and I was thinking about how I was going to die and how I was never going to get to publish that big boy video that I worked so hard on and I didn't actually work hard on, and how my lawnmower train had gone to crap, and how I was not going to get to reveal my big thing on May 22nd and 23rd, and how I was never going to get to convert my lawnmower train to pedal power. And you want to know what the worst part of all is? I never learned to read. So that's the end of the story. That's how I got to be where I am today. A YouTuber with 470 subscribers, a broken lawnmower train, but I still will bring along all my hopes and dreams as I prepare on May 22nd to unveil my new vlog series, where I actually act like myself and not some crazy caricature of myself. So please like, comment, and subscribe for eventual quality, eventually. And now, my ending song.